has changed since we fell in love. Something happened to me and you. We used to act like two people in love. But now we act like we're through. Do you still love me? 'Cause I still love you. Well, lady, why don't we do what we can? Ooh, 'cause I'm hoping we can work it out. I'm hoping we can work it out.
I'm Lee Wilson, owner of Wedding Bliss Event Planners. It's so great to meet you both.
You too.
I'm Charisma Davis. We spoke over the phone, and this is my fiance, David Martin.
I am so happy we can get an appointment with you today.
You come highly recommended on the blog post I follow.
Oh, that's always nice to hear. Well, David, Charisma, let me just say it's great to meet you guys in person, and I'm so excited for the opportunity to plan your special wedding day.
Thanks so much. We're excited too.
I have your online submission form printed here. Let's see, spring wedding, Saturday, June 26th of next year, 150 to 175 guests. That's peak wedding season, so vendors tend to book quickly. Do you guys already have a wedding thing in mind?
Well, I had my heart set on the Grand Chateau Bavere.
Ooh, that's a beautiful venue. Great choice.
I know, isn't it? Too bad they don't have our date available.
Oh, have you considered alternative dates?
Well, June is really important to us. It's the anniversary of our first date, so we like to stick to that date.
Yeah, but we don't have to keep that date.
But I want to. When my dream venue wasn't available, I decided to research reputable wedding planners who can help me find a place I love just as much, which is how I found you.
Okay, I'll make note of that date. Have you thought of a theme or a particular time of day?
Well, we need the most cost-efficient time of day. I mean, now that I think about it, we can get married in the morning, right? Because it's cheaper the earlier, correct?
That's true, David. Events that take place evenings and weekends tend to have a higher premium.
So I envision this elegant sunset wedding with theater-style seating. The Grand Chateau Bavere had this outdoor patio that I really wanted for the ceremony. I can't get over the skyline and the river.
But if you could suggest something, that would be fine. Have you guys discussed your budget?
I don't really even know anything about planning a wedding, so I wouldn't really know where to start as far as a budget. As you can see, Charisma is very excited about the details. But I'll admit, we haven't really had any conversations in regards to price points in relation to the budget.
I understand. The average cost of a wedding in Chicago is about $28,000.
Charisma, really?
I am not suggesting we spend $28,000 on our wedding.
I sure hope not. We don't have $28,000 to spend on anything.
We are expecting 150 guests, though. Let's say we scale back a bit on the venue and do a luncheon for $25 per person, ballpark. You're looking at $3,750 for food plus taxes and gratuity.
So $4,000 on food alone, and that's scaling back?
Well, it also depends if you're hosting an open bar. On average, consider paying $25 to $90 per person. So say $45 per person times 150 is, give me a moment, $6,750. But having a cash bar can reduce that cost.
I don't want our guests to pay for their drinks.
Hypothetically, we're up to $10,000. And Whitney, I'm sure you have a fee for your time and service.
Yes, after we discuss specific needs, I can provide a detailed quote for you.
Detailed quote? So what are we talking about? We talking hundreds? Thousands?
I charge $500 for a day of wedding coordination, and I charge $3,000 for coordination of food, floral, music, venue, etc.
Okay. I see it. I see it. It's a ripoff! I see why people just skip the wedding and just go to the damn courthouse.
David!
What? I mean, no disrespect, but a wedding is a ripoff. Hypothetically, we're up to $15,000? This is crazy!
David, you're being rude. Whitney, I am so sorry. Please excuse my fiance.
I'll give you 2 minutes to talk, and I'll go grab one of our informational brochures for you to review at home.
Thank you again, Whitney. I am so sorry.
Oh, we're talking now? You ain't say anything the whole car ride.
I was too embarrassed to talk.
For the record, you embarrassed yourself. How do you set up a meeting with a high-end wedding planner when your sister already offered to help?
Corinne can't help me look for wedding venues or gowns or flowers. She has too much going on with the kids. She can barely check an email. And you're too busy at work all day, and then you come home and work on the app.
Do you hear yourself? You're mad that I can't daydream wedding venues with you because I'm working to build a better life for us?
I'm mad because I'm the only person putting forth any effort to plan this wedding. You proposed to me, so I thought inviting you to a meeting would get you excited or at least more involved.
I'm not excited. I'm actually mad that I'm the only one thinking about how we're gonna pay for this wedding.
Don't do that. I earn money too.
Yeah, I
don't even want to talk about this. Camped out in the living room because you're still upset. Yeah, sure, buddy.
I don't have time to be mad, Charisma. I gotta get up and get ready for work.
You're already running late.
I know. I overslept.
Babe, I don't want to fight with you anymore.
Okay, Charisma.
Yo, what's really going on with you? Talk to me. When I have articles to write, I still make time for you. You don't want to plan the wedding or even talk about the wedding. You don't want to hang out. You don't want to have sex. Like, what's up?
It's not about that. You know I'm under a lot of pressure to launch. I just don't understand why we can't have a small, simple ceremony for now.
Be honest. Do you still want to get married?
I do. But you need to relax because you're really starting to stress me out.
Okay, more math?
Mm-hmm. Hey, Charisma. Hold on a second.
You can call me back.
No. 2 seconds. Real quick. Okay, Zoe. What is 7 times 9?
63. I put the 3 right here.
Yep, you got this.
5 times 9 is 45.
Yep. All right. Keep going. Go ahead.
Me? What are you doing?
You know, multitasking, helping Zoe with her worksheet, just got the baby down for a nap.
A nap? It's 9 a.m.
Your nephew was so gassy and crying all night. Mama's the one who really needs a nap.
Well, I won't keep you long. I know you're busy with the kids and everything else. I went to a wedding planner yesterday.
For what? I'm planning this wedding. I told you that.
You and I both know you don't come up for air sometimes. And you always complain about having too much on your plate.
This is different. Housework, grad school, raising 2 kids. Hardly has the same excitement as planning my little sister's wedding.
It doesn't matter anyway. David acted a complete fool at the meeting with the wedding planner. I don't think he wants to get married anymore.
Come on, did he say that?
It's not funny, and he didn't have to. It's in his behavior and his attitude. He's distant and he works all the time. This is not the relationship I signed up for.
Girl, you knew he was ambitious when you met him. You loved that about him, remember? Besides, Kevin is working 12-hour shifts. You don't hear me complaining.
It's different. You and Kevin have been married for like eons.
David has changed, Corinne.
Well, you've only been together for a year. Maybe he just has some cold feet.
Then he needs to tell me that.
Mommy?
Hold on a second, Charisma.
No. It's okay. I'll talk to you later.
Are you sure?
Yeah, I'm sure.
Bye.
I'm sorry for stopping by without an appointment.
Oh, it's okay. How are you today?
I'm feeling a little bit overwhelmed and I don't have anyone else to talk to, so I'm here.
Of course. Are the wedding plans overwhelming you?
It's my fiance, David. I don't think he wants to get married. After the meeting with you, I realized his truth and I tried to talk to him about it, but he shut me out.
How long did you two date before becoming engaged?
6 months.
It's not a long time.
I've heard it all from my family. The only person who supports my relationship is my sister.
Do you agree with them in any way?
I didn't at first, but I'm starting to now.
What do you love about David?
I love his drive and determination. I love how smart he is and his zest for knowledge. I also love his cooking.
What don't you like about him?
I don't like how focused he is on work sometimes. It's like I'm not a priority.
And have you shared these feelings with him?
I have. I'm a writer, so I have no issue expressing how I feel.
So if there was no money and no wedding plans, but just the love you have for him, would you still want to marry him?
I love him. He thinks I'm in love with this wedding, but that's not true. He's just such an amazing man, and our relationship is so special that I want to celebrate it in a memorable way. Then I see him all grouchy and emotionally unavailable, and it just
scares you.
Yeah, in a sense. And then I go into reclusion, and I shut down the way he does, and that's not even like me. I like to talk through my problems. He just likes to process them.
Your partner should be your safe space, your sanctuary, your ark of safety. You shouldn't feel alone, and if you do, you must assess why. I know. Love is a risk. You think David is worth the risk of love?
He is.
Then you must dare to love and take the leap. I know your disagreements make you feel at odds. I challenge you to be all in, and not just me.
Decided to show up to work today.
Morning, Jessica.
Hey, you have been showing up late the last few days, and that is not like you.
Yeah, I know. Was Vincent looking for me in a morning meeting?
Yep. He asked that you come into his office when you get in, so.
Oh, damn. I'll tell him I had car trouble or something.
No. Why don't you tell him the truth? Why don't you tell him that you overslept because you were up all night building a tech company so that they could one day lose their beloved information technology specialist? I'm sure he would love it.
You're a professional hater. Do you have business cards, website?
Oh, before I forget, he announced that the Peds are moving to the East Building, so you have to get their computers, phones, and printers set up by Friday.
Friday? Who's going to cover the help desk if I'm there for 2 days?
He asked me to cover today, but I don't know about the other 3 days. You know, it's probably what he wants to talk to you about. How to create a miracle.
Gosh. It's not even 10 a.m. and I'm already exhausted. I was up all night. It's like a race against the clock to try to get this company launched and this app running. I need a strong team of coders, but, you know, money's so tight. I try to do a lot of the legwork myself, but, man, it's like I'm burning the candle at both ends. And Charisma's giving me shit about her dream wedding. And, like, I'm trying to build a dream life right now.
Is it safe to assume that you guys haven't done any premarital counseling?
Oh, it's safe.
I mean, she's about to be your wife, David. It's not too late to get on the same page.
But how can I get on the same page with somebody who's constantly in opposition with me?
Well, have you tried to look at it from her perspective?
Her perspective? It's always about her perspective. You know, we were casual, then she wants to get serious. We get serious, then she wants to move in together. We move in together, then she wants to quit her job and freelance full time. I love her, and I do want to spend my life with her. But whenever I need something, I can't ever seem to get it.
Well, what do you need, and why can't you just tell her that?
I need a partner who understands that I'm trying to achieve something bigger than myself.
Okay, well, I know you don't want to spend the rest of your life in an IT department for a hospital, and certainly not with an unsupportive partner in the process. And I'm no therapist, but if you're spending all your time day and night working as a priority over your relationship, you might not be ready.
Hey, Jessica said you wanted to see me?
Yes. Come on in.
So, sorry I wasn't in the morning meeting. I had some issues with my commute this morning.
It's cool.
Jessica told me pediatrics is moving. I'll get to work on that project ASAP.
Please do. And how are things going down at the help desk with no acting manager these days?
Pretty good. Jessica and I are handling things well, considering all things with the new system.
I know there's a lot going on with staffing these days, but I really appreciate you and Jessica really running things.
Oh. No problem. Thank you.
How do you like working?
I really like working here. I've been here 5 years, and I hope to continually grow with the company.
So you see a long-term future with the company?
Yes, I see a future. This was my first company after I graduated from college, and the first company to give me an opportunity without any professional experience. So yeah, I see a future as long as I can continue to grow.
Okay, that's what I wanted to hear. Let me ask you a personal question if you don't mind.
Sure.
Are you married? Do you have any kids? Are you a homeowner? Well, that's three questions.
I'm not married. I am engaged though. My fiance and I are still trying to figure out our wedding plans. I don't have any kids, and I'm not a homeowner.
What line of work is your fiance?
She is a freelance writer, so she takes on newspaper articles, gigs, or special projects as they come in.
Understood. You're probably wondering why I'm asking you all these questions.
Yeah.
So the network is going through a series of changes across the board, not just at our facility. Two of our hospitals will be closing at the end of the year, and we're building bigger campuses in three major cities. We're also planning to innovate our telehealth division next quarter.
Oh, that's great.
I agree. I'm still fairly new here, but things have been going in the right direction. A few months ago, you expressed interest in the IT director's position after Nelson Fremont's departure from the company.
Yes, and I'm still very interested in that position. I've been working with Nelson since I started here in IT. He's actually the one who trained me when I came in as an associate.
Oh yeah? Well, I've only been over the network for 6 months now, and I appreciate you taking over his responsibilities while we decide what to do with his position.
What to do with?
Yes, the senior management team has plans to merge the IT department here along with the marketing and technology departments in California under Isaac Stevenson's leadership. Between you and I, Isaac plans on retiring very soon.
Oh, okay.
So, I would like to promote you to the role of technology director, taking over for Isaac in San Francisco, and heading both the IT and the marketing and technology departments.
Wait, are you serious?
I told you, we're moving in the right direction. And we need someone with your expertise at the forefront. We know how critical your work ethic is to this company. And it's time that we get some new blood and innovation into management. You have a master's degree in information technology?
Yes, I finished the IT program last year.
This position requires relocation within 2 weeks. Of course, we'll cover all your expenses.
2 weeks?
Are you willing to relocate on such short notice?
Tripping as usual.
No. Not at all. That man's cool with me.
Vincent, cool. Oh, why?
That man just offered me a promotion. In San Francisco.
Oh my god, David. Congratulations. You totally deserve it. I'm so shocked. wow. I was so salty back in the day when you were basically doing Nelson's job. And you totally got past him for a promotion. And then I started and you were training me. And
yeah.
This is so great. What is the position?
It is Director of Technology.
Oh, excuse me, Director of Technology.
But get this. I have to relocate in 2 weeks.
That is so soon. 2 weeks, what are you gonna do? What about the company?
The company's still happening. Vincent didn't talk to me about salary, but if I'm a director, then I can afford to hire my own team to work on my company, build my apps, get contracts. I mean, this is exactly what I needed to position myself in the marketplace.
You totally manifested this.
I think I did. I did. Yeah, I did.
What about charisma in the wedding, though?
I mean, technically, she can work anywhere.
Yeah.
She freelances, so. I mean, her family is here in Chicago, but I mean, I don't know how she's gonna feel about moving. I mean, I can't concentrate on her dream wedding right now. Is it selfish?
You tell me.
Hey, sister. So, Kevin just took the kids with him to the store, so I'm spending my mommy break checking in on you. What you doing?
I am cooking dinner.
Oh, what's the special occasion?
Stop.
You and David kissed and made up, huh?
Not yet, but we're about to. I just don't want to fight while I plan my future with him. So I'm calling a truce. We'll eat pasta, drink wine, and
talk through our issues like highly functioning adults.
Hello? Is there a disconnection? Hello? Is this?
Stop, I'm being serious.
So I finally got through to you, huh?
Actually, it was Whitney, the wedding planner. She asked me if David was worth the risk of love, and I said yeah. She said I had to dare to love and take a leap and be all in, not just when things are going my way.
Well, I don't know what to say about this wedding planner giving relationship advice, but I'm so happy you're feeling better. Because this morning, sis, you sounded so defeated.
I know. I'm feeling much better. I have a newfound perspective, and I just want to get back to happier times.
Good. But you tell that wedding planner to fall back. I'm planning this wedding.
Okay. I gotta go. David's home.
Bye. Hey, babe.
Hey, baby. How you doing?
I'm good now that you're home. I cooked dinner and bought some wine, hoping we can sit down and talk.
It smells amazing, and yes, we do need to talk. Can you come sit down?
Baby, let's eat first. We have all night to talk.
Charisma, come sit down.
Did something bad happen?
Something amazing happened. I got a promotion at work today. Director of Technology in San Francisco.
Did you accept it?
Of course.
Without talking to me about it first.
It's in San Francisco. Silicon Valley, tech capital of the world.
I don't care if it's on the moon, David. You still should have talked to me about it, or at least called.
Where are you going?
What else is there for me to say? You took the job, now what? No need in planning a wedding, right? Those are the words you're struggling to get out, right?
I still want to marry you. I marry you tonight under the stars. But this is my opportunity to fund my dream, launch my tech company, expand my team, and rub shoulders with the right people.
Keyword, my dream, my tech company, my team.
But I'm doing this for us. Keyword, us. We can have a quick ceremony and plan a bigger wedding later down the line in a year or two.
I get it, David, and I am so truly happy for you. Congratulations.
But
what do you need from me?
I need your love and support in making one of the biggest decisions that I ever had to make. And I want you to move to California with me in 2 weeks, or a little later if you want more time.
If I want more time? How much time would you grant me, King David? 2 months? Or maybe the 2 years you'll need to get ready to get married?
Okay. This is going left, and this is why I didn't tell you sooner. You know, I spent the last 5 hours hyped up, knowing that hard work and perseverance paid off. And I just hope you wouldn't react this way.
I guess neither one of us is getting what we want tonight.
Well, I don't know what to say. See, because I remember you. Said you needed time away. And I told you that was cool. Now you're wishing it was us. But now it could never be. You should have waited for me.
I'm so sorry for wrecking your flow.
No worries, baby's crying.
How's the article coming along?
It's coming. It's a struggle to write how-to tips on single life when you're newly single. The things I do for a paycheck.
Hello? It's not over between you and David. You haven't seen him or talked to him since your fight. I feel like now that you've had some time away from him, you can come together, sit down, and really talk about your future.
Corinne, you've always been a hopeless romantic. It's a wrap. I've been staying here for like 10 days. He hasn't called, he hasn't come by, but he did text me about breaking our lease.
Are you sure you don't want to go to Cali with him? A lot of women in your position would jump at the chance.
Going to California reinforces the idea that his dreams are more important than mine.
But what if it was your job in Cali and he decided not to go with you? What do you feel about?
I don't know. I'm still figuring things out. Being a freelance writer, I'm learning myself every day. I know I want to be with him. I just don't want to feel less than. Does that make sense?
Okay, sister, you know I'll always have your back, but do you envy his success? Do you resent it? Okay, no more questions. I'll let you get back to your article.
Jessica! Oh. What up, girl?
Ooh, someone's ready for their last day.
It's a little bittersweet.
I got you a little gift.
No, you didn't. No, you know. Champagne!
Yeah. I know your big bosses are hosting a little going away party for you later. But I wanted to give you my speech now, because you know I don't like crowds like that. So.
Ooh, let's hear it. Yeah. Let's go.
Okay. All right. Get into character. David, I am mad at you because you are leaving me in this crazy place. But I could not be happier to see your dreams unfolding. You deserve all of the good things that come with following your dreams. The adventures, the successes, but most importantly, the opportunities. So, coffee mug in hand, cheers to you, David.
Very nice.
Thank you
so much. I really appreciate it.
Now your turn. Speech. Yes.
Man, this job has been a wild ride. I learned a lot, even though I hated it here most days. And I envisioned my last day for quite some time. I was tested over and over and over again, and passed over for more promotions than one can imagine. In 5 years, I survived two horrible bosses.
Oh, shout out to Chuck and Larry, wherever you are.
I got my master's degree while working here.
Yeah.
I decided to start my company while I was working here. And I'm just really proud of myself and grateful to have coworkers that made every day that much easier. So, Jessica, thank you for the laughter, the friendship, and your hard work. I really appreciate you.
Very sweet. IT's finest right there, ladies and gentlemen. Okay, do you think it's too early to pop this? I'm just gonna get started. Yeah. haven't talked about it that much, but is that picture frame going to be on your desk in California?
No, I don't think so. She's still adamant about not going.
I'm really sorry, David. Maybe you guys could like do the long distance thing, you know, to work through it. I'm sure she'll come around.
She wants it to be over. I spent the last few days accepting the fact that I'm not as ready for marriage as I thought when I proposed. When I did, something in charisma just kind of took off. She skyrocketed 10 years ahead. And I want my money and my life to be ready when I decide to raise a family. Whenever that is. But this is where I am today. I like to think that it all makes sense somehow. That it'll be worth the risk of love or love lost. However you look at it, I hope to be my happiest self from this decision.
You will. So, don't give up.
You should keep the photo album.
I don't want it.
You don't?
I mean, I'm not going to sip tea and look at memories one Sunday afternoon. We're breaking up and moving apart, David.
Just for now, Charisma.
Yeah, for now.
What? You're the one that doesn't want long distance.
Well, you didn't exactly fight me on it.
Why the hell would I fight you on that?
Not fight me. Fight for us. For every memory in the photo album.
I can't win. Nothing on this planet will ever make you happy.
I guess that's not your problem anymore, is it?
You see what I mean? That's that emotional warfare bullshit I'm talking about. You're always ready for combat. I'm on your side, Charisma. I'm trying to make a better life for you.
Yeah, 3,000 miles away from my family. Real good job, David. You're not making my life any better. You're sending me on a whirlwind. I can't afford this apartment by myself. You think I'm gonna stay at my sister's house with her two kids running around? I don't want that.
You don't have to do anything you don't want to do. And we both know you wouldn't do that anyway. You could easily hop on a plane and come to San Francisco with me. You know how much this promotion means to me. But from the first moment we met, it's been about what Charisma wants and what Charisma needs. You know what? Let's quit playing ourselves. You don't want a life with me. You don't want to build a business with me. You don't want to get married to me, have kids with me, grow old with me, right?
I don't know.
I'm right, and you know I'm right. You know what? I need some air.
You should just go. I'll finish clearing the apartment by myself.
You know I can't do that.
Please, I got it. You already took your clothes out. I'll finish the rest. I just can't sit here working with you on this, pretending not to acknowledge our reality. Please, I can't do it.
Can I at least get a hug goodbye?
I'm sorry, David. I can't do that either.